Today we're going to use two QNAP TS-431P NAS units to demonstrate the creation of two dynamic link aggregation groups, or LAGs, on a TP-Link 24-port gigabit managed switch. The model number of the switch that we'll use is the TL-SG2424V2. Dynamic link aggregation using the 802.3AD standard, also known as port trunking, allows you to group multiple Ethernet interfaces together to create one logical link. This increases bandwidth when multiple users are transferring files across the linked LAN ports, and provides redundancy when one of the ports fails. The two QNAP TS-431P network attached storage units have two LAN ports each. The first QNAP is named PSI, and the second one is named PHY. I'll use both ports on each device and set up two LAGs on the switch. So on the QNAP named PSI, I'll plug in an Ethernet cable into each port, and then on the managed switch, I'll use ports 15 and 16. The QNAP named PHY is going to use both ports as well. And those will plug into ports 17 and 18. Let's log into the TP-Link switch first. The first screen shows that I've got ports 15 and 16 connected to the first QNAP, and 17 and 18 connected to the second one. Now on my network, I have a whole slew of other devices connected to the switch, which I didn't show in the previous clip, but we can ignore those for now. The only ports that we're concerned about are 15 and 16, which will group together as one trunk, and 17 and 18 for the second trunk. Click on Switching, and then LAG, and head to the LACP Config tab. Scroll down to the first two ports, 15 and 16, select them, and set the mode to active, status to enable, and the admin key to 1, and then apply. For the second link aggregation group, select ports 17 and 18, but this time set the admin key to 2. Setting mode to active and status to enable, and then hit apply. Now we need to configure the NAS devices to set up the trunks on the QNAP side. Let's log into the QNAP TS-431P named PSI, go to Control Panel, click Network, and you'll see we have the two LAN ports active. I've assigned the first port a static IP address, while the second one is just getting its address from the DHCP server. In the end, after we bond these together, the group will take the IP of the static address. You'll want to click the port trunking button, choose IEEE 802.3AD, and select both LAN ports. If you want to change the default hash policy, you can click on the little pencil icon next to the IEEE 802.3AD. But I'll just leave it on the default for now and hit Apply. At this point, the QNAP has to reconnect using the LAG, so you will need to wait about 40 seconds to re-establish contact. I'll cut the video here to speed things up, and you won't even notice it. Once the refresh link appears, we'll see that the trunk is established. Now we'll do the same thing to the QNAP named PHY. Again, we'll go to the Control Panel and Network, and we'll combine the two ports by going to Port Trunking. Set it to IEEE 802.3AD, select the two ports again, and hit Apply. After reconnecting, we see the trunk has been created successfully. As we go back to the TP-Link, you'll see things haven't refreshed yet on the LACP screen, so let's click on LAG to refresh the information. Tabbing to LACP Config, you'll see that the LAG groups have been created. Hitting the LAG table, you'll see ports 15 and 16 are part of LAG 1, and 17 and 18 are part of LAG 2. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.